Yes. So here, beta, today we would like to study about the momentum. As I explained that to you, that in your previous class, that momentum is defined as the product of mass into velocity. Okay. Momentum is defined as the product of mass into velocity. Either you can say that, or relative velocity, you can say that. Okay. Why we generally use to say relative velocity? Okay. So relative velocity, that means you have to understand that you have to analyze your velocity to other objects' velocity. Okay. Yes. Means you can also understand that in this way. Suppose that in your previous class I explained that to you, that suppose that your brother is running towards you and you are also running towards him. Okay. So in that condition, as usual, your both of your body mass, that is different or not?
Yes.
Yeah, means it means that suppose that you are 40 kg or your brother that is of 35-38 kg. So that means if you have different masses, okay, so in that condition that your momentum, that will also different. Okay. And also momentum also assigns the velocity of object. Okay. That means suppose that when your momentum, when your mass, that will be greater than 100% your momentum, that will also greater. Okay.
Yes.
Clear. So if miss before collision, okay, suppose that your mass is m1, your brother's mass is m2, your velocity is u1 and your brother's velocity is u2. Okay, here beta, u1 and u2. Okay, wait, hold on, give me a second. Actually, I have to explain that on a screen. Let me take my graphic tablet. Yes, I'm back. Let me open. Yes, let me take my receiver. Yeah, give me 1 second. Yes. So, as explaining that to you, beta, are you able to hear me clearly?
Yes.
Okay, great. So, suppose that you are moving, suppose that your mass is m1, your brother mass, that is your m2, okay, your velocity, that is u1, okay, your brother velocity, that is u2, before collision. Okay, as I explained that to you, that means you are moving towards your brother and your brother is moving towards you. Regarding to that one, and your mass is m1, your and velocity, that is u1, and your brother's mass is u2 and velocity is mass is u2 and velocity is u2. Okay. So in that way, what will be momentum of your both? So that means in that condition, if you multiply these two, okay, so that means it can be defined as P1 equals to M1 U1, okay, and again here it will be P2 equals to M2 U2, okay.
Yes.
Always remember that initial velocity in many of books around the world, there becomes initial velocity, that can also be taken initial velocity can be assigned as u. Okay, and always remember that final velocity that can be assigned as v. Clear?
Yeah.
So when you will collide, okay, means when two objects are here, they are moving towards each other, and then one condition will come when they will collide. Okay.
Yes.
And after collision, 100% chance will be that the object would like to change their speed or change their velocity or change their direction. Okay.
Yes.
After collision, the object will change their speed, velocity or direction. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. After collision, objects will change. Give me 1 second. Sorry. So here will change their velocity and speed. Velocity or direction. Okay.
Yes.
Clear, beta? You understand up to here?
Yes.
So the and then after means after changing velocity or direction, let us consider now in green in color. Then after collision, I am writing here after collision. Okay, suppose that now your velocity is v1. Okay.
Yes.
And your brother velocity, that will be v2. Okay.
Yes.
But still your mass will be m1 and his mass will be m2. Clear?
Yes.
So after collision, what will be your momentum? You can see that it will be p3 equals to m1 v1 and p4 equals to m2 v2. Clear?
Yes.
So now according to the conservation of momentum, okay, according to the conservation of momentum, okay, that means momentum before the collision, yeah, according to conservation of momentum. So according to the conservation of momentum, always remember that momentum before collision, okay, momentum of the object before the collision, okay, momentum before collision equals to momentum after collision. Okay.
Yes.
Are you understanding that?
Yes.
So beta, before collision, that means your momentum was p1. Okay. Your brother momentum was p2. Okay. So before collision, your both momentum will be what? Your both momentum, that will be p1 plus p2 or not?
Yes.
Great. And after collision, that will be p3 plus p4. Clear? Or you can also understand in this way. Suppose that it will be like m1 u1 plus m2 u2, okay, equals to m1 v1 equals plus m2 v2. Okay. So if you will see anywhere about conservation of momentum, so either your above equation that I had written, that p1 plus p2 equals to p3 plus p4, that will be written there, or it will be written in this way, like m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2, where m1 and m2 are the masses of the objects, and u1, u2 are the initial velocities, and v1, v2 are the final velocities. Clear?
Yes.
Do you understand clearly?
Yes.
Fantastic. Also, beta, so what I explained that just before, Firstly, I explained that momentum is defined as the product of mass into velocity. Also, the second thing, momentum, that is defined by letter P, okay? And also, it's a unit, that is kilogram meter per second, okay? It's a unit. Yeah, here you can see that your unit is written here. Wait, hold on. Your unit is written here, kilogram meter per second, okay?
Yes.
It is your unit, okay?
Yes.
Yeah, unit or SI unit, you can say that. SI unit, that is kilogram meter per second. So suppose that means and formula that you can see over here, P equals to MV, that will be your formula, okay?
Yes.
So means basically 1 marks question that would like to come in your test or exam, that means I need two of the quantities that will be given to you and you have to find the third one, okay?
Yes.
So regarding to this one, P equals to M into V. Okay, I am writing on right inside here. So fundamental formula, that is equals to P equals to M into V. Okay. Suppose that if you want to make M as subject. Okay. So mass from here, you can find mass equals to momentum upon velocity. Okay. Or you can see that velocity equals to momentum upon mass. Okay?
Yes.
Understand? So these three formulas that you have to keep in your mind. If you are not able to learn all the three, so simply that you have to learn of your fundamental formula and then only you have to plug in any two of the values that will be given in your question and then you have to simplify and you will get your answer. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. And now next thing is direction. So always remember beta that when two objects that will collide, so 100% their direction that will change. Why? Because their velocity will also change. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. So that is momentum here means that is what I mean to say. I mean to say that momentum doesn't depend not only the object mass and speed. Okay. Velocity, that is the speed in a particular direction, okay? Because as usual, in your previous classes, I explained that to you velocity is a vector quantity, okay? And also I explained that to you, can you tell me that what is vector quantity?
You didn't explain what vector quantity was.
Oh my god. Sorry, beta. So first of all that I'm going to explain you that what is a scalar and vector quantity. Just see downwards, okay? So scalar quantity, but I think I explained that to you, beta. Do you remember that? I think that you will remember that when I will explain again that. Beta, scalar quantity, that means quantities which have only magnitude, okay? Only magnitude but
okay.
No direction, okay?
Oh yes.
Now you remember that I explained that or not?
Yes.
Eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then vector quantity. Okay, no problem, but I am repeating again that so that you will be able to understand more clearly. A-N-T-I-T-Y. So vector quantity, that means which contains means magnitude and direction both. Okay, clear? So scalar quantity, beta, you can take example, a little bit example I am writing on your right hand side. So here of this example that is you can take over here like distance distance, force, okay, mass, okay, all these they are, because you can see that distance, that means like 5 kilometer, okay? 5 kilometer. Force, suppose that 10 newton. Okay, mass, that means 5 kilogram, or just like us. Okay, but here you are seeing that none of them have direction. Okay, we suppose that if I would like to ask that what is the distance between India and Australia, then you would like to see that sir, maybe millions of kilometer or thousands of kilometer. So yes, you are right, but there you will not tell me that in which direction. Okay, I am asking only about the distance between the India and Australia. I am not asking about the direction. Okay, so that means that's why that distance is not a vector quantity, because there is only magnitude. Clear?
Yes.
Also, force, suppose that if anyone is hitting you, okay, or if anyone hit you, then in that condition, if I would like to ask you that, oh my god, it hurts you a lot, then you would like to say that, then I would ask you that, did you hurt a lot? Then you will say that, yes sir, he or she hit me in a high force. Okay, so with a high force, that means there will be only magnitude. Magnitude, that means you can, yeah, here you can clearly understand distance, that will be in meter, force, that will be in newton. Okay, and mass, that will be in kilogram. Okay, so here in each and every quantity, you are not explaining about direction. Okay.
Yes.
Are you okay?
Yes, yes.
Oh, great. So next one is your vector quantity, beta. So as I explained about vector quantity, so it contains both magnitude and direction. Okay, so example, if you want to write there, so example, that will be your velocity. So velocity also, you can see that, suppose that you are moving in a plane, okay, and if there is a little bit problem in plane, and then operator who is on earth, then he would like to ask to pilot that what is the problem, and also he would like to ask about the, I mean, the exact location. Okay, so in that condition, pilot, what will be the pilot reply? Okay, suppose that I am pilot, then if operator would like to ask me about the problem and my location, then I would like to say that, sir, we are flying at 900 miles per hour in northeast direction. Okay.
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
Good. So that means, beta, velocity, that means 900 miles, okay, in northeast direction. Okay, so that means direction also that I am explaining to you. Okay.
Yes.
Clear, beta? Work. Work is also your vector quantity, beta. Why? Because if you would like to see that work means definition of work, or you can define that work equals to product of force into direction, force into distance. Okay, force, yes, into distance, or W equals to F into D. Okay, so yes, force into the distance, force and distance, and force will apply in the direction and displacement. Force into distance, either you can see that, or sometimes that displacement, that somewhere that also displacement you can write there. Displacement, yeah, force into displacement. So that means displacement will be in the direction of applied force. Okay, suppose that here is a table. Okay, here is a table. If you will apply a force, okay, hold on, if you'll apply force in this direction, okay, like F, okay, and also the table would like to displace a little bit in the same direction, okay, then you, yeah, have to understand that you are doing work. Okay.
Yes.
Means I mean to say that you applied force in this direction and table is also displaced in the same direction. That means you did work. Or suppose that if you are applying force in this direction and table is moving in this direction, so there will be no force. Okay. Sorry, no work. Sorry, no work. Why? Because force will, work will only be considered when the displacement of the object will be in the same direction of applied force. Okay?
Yes.
Understand?
Yes.
No work because direction is changed. Clear?
Yes.
Do you understand that?
Yes.
Great. So that means in that way, in that way, so in that way, in that, do you understand all that which I explained that to you?
Yes.
Great. Very good, beta. So also it means doesn't believe on me. You don't have to believe on me. It doesn't mean that you don't have to believe on me. Means I mean to say that don't believe on me. Don't believe on any other person. Whatever that will be written on your book, that you will believe or not.
No.
So here you can see clearly that momentum does not just depend on the object mass and speed. Velocity is the speed in the particular direction. So you can say that momentum of an object also depends on the direction of travel.
Yes.
Yes. So suppose that if two object will collide, okay. If two object will collide to each other, and if they would like to change their direction, suppose that firstly they are moving here and here, okay. After collision, give me one second. After collision, if they would like to change their direction, or suppose that one would like to move over here, another would like to move over here, okay. So in that condition, we can also understand clearly that momentum, okay, that is also a type of cause which would like to change the direction of objects, okay, if they will tend to collide each other, okay?
Yes.
Do you understand that?
Yes.
Great. Now. Okay, but I'm going to refresh that so that and after your class, when you would like to see this video, 100% that you will get your efficiency, beta, no doubt. Okay?
Yes.
So, give me a second. I'm refreshing that, beta, so that we can move to the next page.
Yes.
It's coming. Yeah, I'm opening the next page. Yes. Here we go. Yeah. Oh, my God. Now you can see clearly, beta, what I explained that to you in your previous page, the same yeah. thing that they are explaining over here, okay? Conservation of momentum, okay? Conservation of momentum. So that means always remember that if two objects are, okay, wait. I can underline here. I can explain you in my words over here. I am also writing there, okay? If two object of different masses and velocities, okay, velocities will collide, okay, collide each other. Then, now the main thing that is here, then, momentum before the collision, will always equals to momentum after collision, okay?
Okay.
Understand clearly, beta?
Yes.
So a little bit, because I had explained that to you in your previous page, so a little bit in a means roughly that I am explaining that to you, that means suppose that two object of masses m1 and m2 m1 plus m2 wait and equals to m1 plus m2 here, and now their velocity, that you can also assign a value over there, m1 u1 M2, U2, first M1, V1, and M2, V2. Clear, Bete?
Yes.
Yeah. Or in a very, very convenient manner, you can also learn that P1 plus P2 equals to P3 plus P4. Okay? Understand?
Yes.
Yeah. And momentum calculation. So as usual, fundamentally, you know that the momentum is defined as the product of mass into relative velocity, or simply you can understand that means velocity of the object. So in that way, that you can plug in your values and you will get your answer. Okay, wait, hold on. I think, okay, yeah, here, just see your this example. Here they are saying that two railway carriages collide and move off together. Okay.
Yes.
Now, carriage A has the mass of 12,000 kilograms. Okay, dear. So, you can see here that it is mass of first carriage. That is, what is this one? It is your M1, okay?
Yes.
And 5 meter per second, that is your U1, okay?
Yes.
And, okay, before collision, okay? And carriage B has a mass of 8,000 kilograms, that means it will be your M2, okay? And is stationary before the collision. What is the velocity of two carriages after the collision, okay? Okay, no problem. So that means M1 is given, U1 is given, M2 is given, okay? Carriage B has a mass of this and is at stationary, okay? Stationary, that means
yes.
U2, that will be 0 beta, okay?
Yes.
Means beta, suppose that you are at rest position in that condition, suppose that, okay, if any other object or any person would like to collide you, okay, so if you are in rest position, so your momentum will be 0 or not?
Yes.
Yeah. So in that condition, and then beta, momentum of your first cartridge, that will be 12,000, that is mass into velocity, 12,000 into 5, okay, 12,000 is 60, great. Are you able to see on your screen here, where I ticked here?
Yes.
That is M1, U1, okay, that is this. And momentum of cartridge B before collision, so that means it is your M2 and it is your U2. Where, because it is in a stationary condition, that's why it will be 0. And now, so that means before collision, what will be your total momentum? So that means clearly you can see that 60,000 kilogram per meter per second plus 0. That means 60,000, that will be your before collision, okay? Momentum before collision, okay? Do you understand that?
Okay, yes.
Great. Now, second step is that after collision, okay, they are saying that after collision, what is the velocity of two cartridges after the collision? Okay. So, because as usual, you know that according to conservation of momentum, okay, momentum before collision, okay, and momentum after collision, that will be same, okay.
Yes.
So before collision, there were two separate objects, okay? When they will collide, then their mass will be combined or not, beta?
Yes, it will be.
Yes. So in that condition, now you can see that first mass is your 12,000 kg and then plus 8,000 kg, okay?
Yes.
So it will be your combined mass when two objects will combine. So it will be 20,000, okay, kg.
Yes.
It will be 20,000 kg. Now they are asking for velocity. Asking velocity, that is V, okay. So simply you have to consider that let the velocity be V, okay. Understand? Then you have to do that 60,000 kilogram meter per second. Equals to 20,000 into V, okay? Means I mean to say this one, I am writing over here. Therefore, 60,000 kilogram meter per second equals to 20,000 into V or not?
Yes.
Then V equals to 60,000 upon 20,000, and then this 3, okay? That means V equals to 3 meter per second. Do you understand it? That means after collision, the object would like to move from each other at a speed of 3 meter per second. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Great. Yeah, you can see here. Okay? Yeah, where I circled here. Okay?
Yes.
Very good. So, is there anything which you want to ask to me before changing page?
No. So the answer to the whole, so the answer would be 3 meters
per second. Yeah. We suppose that after collision, the object would like to move at the velocity of 3 meters per second. Okay?
Yes. Okay.
Clear?
Yes.
Okay. So now again, I'm going to show you. Refresh button so that the next page we can move over there. Now yes, that's the third page. Yeah, now it is came. Yes. Also beta, next topic here you are seeing that force and momentum. Oh, force, I explained that to you before, but no problem. I'm explaining a little bit about force again. As I explained that to you in your previous classes, beta, and also you know about that in your previous class also, I explained that to you about force. Force is the type of push or pull, okay? Do you think that I have to write? I have to explain you in written or simply verbally that you will be able to understand that? Hello?
Hello?
I'm asking that. Do you think that I have to explain that in written about force?
No. No, it's okay. I'll just write it down.
Yeah. No. You don't have to write down, beta, because I'm explaining verbally. So if there will be any problem, then you can say, you have to ask to me and then I'll explain that in written. Okay. So fundamentally, just listen carefully that force. Force is defined as the type of push or pull, which generally tends to move or stop an object. Okay?
Yes.
Fundamentally, there are two types of forces, contact forces and non-contact forces. Contact forces will be applicable only there where the two objects will be in physical contact. Okay? Clear?
Yes.
And non-contact forces, that will be those forces when two objects that will not be in contact to each other. For contact force example, you can take that friction force, okay? Because when, I remember that in your first class or second class, I explained this one to you in a very deep manner. Okay, so if you want to understand also in a deep manner, then just go to my channel and see my video related to force and all that topic, force, distance, okay? And then you will be clearly understand that, okay? And still, if you will feel problem, you are feeling problem, then you can ask me in your class, okay, next week. So, and non-contact force, but I also explained that to you. Can you tell me the example of non-contact force, if you remember?
Gravitational force.
You are seeing from your notes?
Yes.
But why, beta? You have to learn each and everything which I will explain to you in your class, okay? Because as usual, you can see that your classes that would like to be for 2 days in a week, okay? Almost that after 1 week that your classes would like to be, so that in that way, you have sufficient time to learn that, okay?
Yes.
So please, I'm requesting that to you, beta. That means you have to learn in a such an intense that you don't have to turn off your pages, okay?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. Thanks a lot, beta. Thanks for understanding. Yes, because that in that way, beta, your confidence will also develop. Yes, because that in that way that you will understand that, oh yes, sir, I had explained that to you. And So, do you understand, beta, what I mean to say?
Yes.
Great. So, next, beta, momentum. Just I explained that to you. Okay. So, in that way, okay, in that way, you can clearly understand that these two things are not. I'm asking that, beta. Do you understand these two factors clearly?
Yes.
Great. So now, okay, so let me see that what is given again over here. So a little bit, I'm choosing red letters. So beta, yes, force can be also calculated by change in momentum upon time, okay?
Yes.
Change in momentum upon time, okay? And also here, in this section also we would like to study about how to calculate the force involving in changing the momentum of object, okay?
Yes.
Yes, so that means you can also write there F equals to change in momentum, okay? That means P2 minus P1 over T, okay?
Yes.
Or indirectly also you can understand that T2 minus T1 also over there, okay? But yes, fundamentally you can also understand that T, okay? So where force that will be, that is will be considered in Newton, okay? And change in momentum that will be considered in kilogram meter per second. Yeah, because that fundamentally beta momentum, that unit is kilogram meter per second. So change in momentum unit that will also be the same, huh?
Yes.
Understand?
Yes.
Great. So here you are seeing an example by the example of which they are explaining that to you. So here they are saying that what force is needed to get a 25 kilogram stationary bicycle, okay? Mass is given, beta, okay? And stationary, that is V, U is zero, okay?
Yes.
Okay, bicycle moving at 12 meter in 5 seconds, okay? So firstly, means P1, yeah, firstly you have to find out that P1, V1. So P1 that will be your M1, V1, so that is 25 into 0, okay? That will be, yeah, 0. P2, that will be 25 into 12, okay? Understand?
Yes.
Yeah, so in that condition it will be 300, okay? Kilogram meter per second, okay? And now, beta, force, that means F, as usual you know that, in and time, that is also given, okay? T, that is given 5 seconds, okay? So yes, force, that will be P2 minus P1 upon T. So that means clearly, means here you are seeing that I am applying the formula, which I explained that just before, just above. So here you can see that 300 minus 0 over 5. So it will be 60 Newton, okay? That will be your force, okay?
Yeah.
Understand?
Yes. Yes.
Great. You know that, I will explain that your type of triangle there is also become, by which you will be able to understand that clearly, okay? Okay, let me, yes, make some space. Oh yes, my God, here is also given. It is your triangle, okay? Change in momentum, that is force into time, okay? So if any two quantities in this triangle that will be given to you, then 100% that you will be able to find the third one or not?
Yes.
Yeah, great. Beta, are you understanding all that which I am explaining to you?
Yes.
Fantastic, beta. Yes, yes. If you are feeling a little bit problem, then you can tell me, I will explain that to you again. Yes. Yes,
okay.
So it is. Yeah, pardon?
Yes.
So it is a very important triangle, beta. Now let's get down over there. Yes. Force can also be calculated. F equals to, force equals to mass into acceleration, or you can understand that F equals to M into A. Okay? F equals to,
yes,
M into A. So also you can see that, and above I explained that to you, means additional knowledge that is here, what I am explaining that to you. Means in your previous equation that you know that P2 minus P1 upon time, that is your force, and also F equals to M into A, that is also your force. So here by these, if you would like to combine these two things, then you can also find your acceleration over there. Acceleration, that means it will be P2 minus P1 upon M times T. Okay? Understand?
Yes.
Yeah, so it's additional knowledge. But suppose that if two objects, their velocities and momentum, that is given to you, and their time, okay, that is also given. So in that way, you can find your acceleration with the help of this formula. Okay?
Yes.
Do you understand clearly?
Yes.
Good. I am going to share my screen again. Give me 1 second.
So to find the accelerations, it's P1 minus P2 over mass times time.
Yeah, mass times time. Yeah, you can also do that. I mean, if that will be, but I don't think that that type of question will come in your course, okay? Because that's the additional knowledge which I give to you. Oh, I have to change the screen. Give me 1 second. Yeah, here we are. Wow, Newton's third law of motion. Firstly, I have to explain you about in my language, that means third law explains that miss standard definition I have to write, so that I have to write in this way. Beta, I am explaining in a very convenient way about Newton's third law of motion. Okay, miss, yes. Here I miss whatever definition, actually whatever definition that we generally used to study from miss when I was in your grade, and now almost 90-95% students they are studying. Okay, but within means a few years, that this rule, okay, or this law is a little bit means change. Okay, so the changed law, that is under, just see that, under some specific, okay, specific condition of matter. Okay, I'll explain about that. What does this sentence mean? Okay, under some specific condition of matter. Okay, now your main thing is, I'm writing here, okay, every action has equal and opposite reaction. Okay?
Yes.
Now most important thing is that, yes, one question that would like to come in your mind, that sir, what you are writing here under some specific condition of matter, you can also understand that in this way. Suppose that if you are applying, there is a wall, and in that way you are applying a type of force over that. Suppose that 50 Newton of force that you are applying over here. Okay, so 100%, okay, under the precision condition, okay, or precise value, okay, you will, if you will apply the 50 Newton of force on the wall, then wall will also apply approximately that 49.9 Newton of force towards you in the opposite direction in which you are applying force. Okay?
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
So here you can see that it is your wall. Okay? Wall or concrete wall. Now, just take a cushion. Okay? What? Cushion or pillow? Pillow, okay?
Yes.
Pillow. If you will apply 50 Newton of force on the pillow, okay? Is it possible that pillow will, yes, also apply the same force on you?
Yes.
No. Suppose that if you will apply 50 Newton of force on a pillow, okay, because pillow is a spongy material, okay?
Yes.
Spongy material, okay?
Yes.
Spongy material, that means having having space in it. So as pillow is your spongy material, so whatever force of 50 Newton that you will apply, it will absorb all the force, okay? It will absorb all the force in it, and the very least amount of force that it will revert back, okay?
Yes.
Understand? Give me a second. I have to choose a different color. Sorry. Wait, black, we can choose that. So 100% it will be only 20 to 30 Newton of force that it will revert back, okay?
Yes.
So here you are seeing that both conditions are same, okay? But only there is a matter of matter, okay? By yes. which the two objects are made up of on which you are applying force. Clear?
Yes.
That's why I wrote here, under some specific condition of matter, every action has equal and opposite reaction. All the substances which are in solid state, they will follow the Newton's third law of motion. But if the object that would like to be with respect to different matter, then they will not follow the Newton's third law of motion. For example,
So liquids and gases don't follow the rule.
Yes. Liquid and gases. You can also understand that suppose that 50 Newton of force that you are applying on a wall, and 49.9 Newton of force that wall is also applying on you in the opposite direction in which you are applying force. Okay?
Yes.
Secondly, suppose that same 50 Newton of force that you are applying on water, okay? Then it is not possible that water will also apply the same 50 Newton of force on you. No. Okay? Because water, that is the type of matter which is made up of million trillions of particles, okay? Which contains space between them. So whatever force that you will apply on water, okay, that means you are applying force, that means you are indirectly, yet you are transferring an energy from you to water or not?
Yes.
Okay, I'm repeating my words. If you are applying 50 Newton of force on water, okay, so that means in that condition, as water contains space between the molecules, that's why that indirectly whatever force or whatever energy you are transferring from you to water, the water would like to absorb all the energy and little bit it would like to get back. Okay?
Oh.
That's why it is not possible that here with respect to water, Newton's third law will be applicable there. Okay?
Yes.
Do you understand that?
Yes.
Yes, that's great. So, I explained in very, very convenient way, beta. So I'm going to refresh the page so that let's see that was given on the last one. Yes, let me open the last here. Okay, car safety feature. Okay, I don't think that I have to explain that to you. But actually, car safety features, that means suppose that if your car will crash, okay? So in that condition, car and its contents, okay, and the passengers, that decelerate rapidly, okay? That means they decelerate, that means they will lose their velocity very quickly, okay?
Yes.
Decelerate, that means... opposite of acceleration, okay? That means condition in which object will tends to come to rest quickly, okay?
Yes.
Understand? So that is your deceleration, okay? So it in that condition, they will means all the passengers will like to feel a great force, okay? Because their change of momentum, that will be at a sudden, okay? And that's why that they will they will feel a type of means a heavy magnitude of jerk, okay, and which would like to get injury, okay, which would like to affect their body, okay, and they will get injury. Understand? That's why that in modern cars, when means just there becomes a type of safety rules and safety features that are also in all the cars, like seat belt, airbag, and crumple zones. Okay, so seat belt, that means always, that's why that traffic police always advise us to have seat belt while riding. Okay, also there becomes airbag. If your car is moving up to minimum of 45 to 50 kilometer per hour, and if that will hit by something else, okay?
Yes.
Then in that way the airbags, okay, airbags that would like to blow in the opposite direction of your motion, okay? Means suppose that when car will hit the ground or tree or anywhere, okay, so and you are sitting over here, okay, you are sitting over here, so here will be on your steering, there will be car means airbags which would like to blow up in the opposite direction, okay, and then whatever is stuck due to change in momentum that you will feel, that will be totally exerted by totally hold by this airbag, okay, and you will save in that condition. Clear?
Yes.
Are you understanding what I am explaining to you?
Yes.
Great. So let's move to the next one. Okay. Oh yes, yes. Seat belt, airbag, crumple zone. Okay, seat belt, I explained that to you. Seat belts stop you tumbling around inside the car if there is a collision. However, they are designed to stretch a bit in collision. Okay. At increase the time taken of the body's momentum to reach to zero and so reduce the forces on it. Secondly, airbag. Airbag also increases the time taken for the head's momentum to reach zero. Okay, so that means when your car would like to hit, okay, in that condition, within few seconds or in part of a second, that the airbag that would like to blow in the opposite direction, and it will prevent your head for any type of injury. Okay?
Yes.
Clear? Third one is your crumple zones. Crumple zones are those type of areas, okay, which are means very sensitive, okay, and also very sensitive. So that means when any type of crush will be there, very quickly they would like to deform, or very quickly they would like to change their shape or size. Why? Because that when your car will hit from the front, so your bonnet and all the other parts including engine, okay, they would like to crump very quickly. Okay, so why they would like to crump very quickly? Because that they would like to hold all the jerk that would like to come in the opposite direction. Okay.
Oh yes.
Clear?
Yes. Sir, what happens if the collision is from the side?
If the collision from the side, but the same thing that will be in suppose that crumple zones also that there is, okay, rear crumple zone, that is back, okay, front, back. If car would like to stuck by any other vehicle by through back, okay, so it would like to squeeze up to here, okay, but all the passengers that would like to sit over here inside, they will save, okay. Yes. And also the same thing, that means from the front, if the car is stucking, in that condition all the shape or size of the car and its accessories, or means its visor, all the things that would like to change their shape or size, that means what, if they are changing their shape or size, that means they are absorbing all the jerk, okay, which would like to affect you, okay, and then in that way that you will save in both the condition, okay. But a little bit, if your car is means crushing from a side, then that's why that there will be a very less possibility, okay, to survive. Yes.
Oh, so the sides don't have crumple zones.
Yeah, so in that condition, that's a very critical zones. Yeah, side, that means sideways near to driver, okay, or driver side, that is a very, very sensitive zone, okay? Yes. In that condition, it may be possible, suppose that if any other person is not sitting beside him or her, in that condition, suppose that if a heat will be on this side, then this portion that would like to squeeze, okay? And then it may be that the driver would like to move a little bit away from its original position, okay? And a little bit possibility will be there to be safe, okay?
Yes.
So thanks for today, beta. I hope you understand and also enjoyed of your today's this time class, beta. Next class will be after 4 hours, okay? 3 or 4 hours, okay? So you have to revise all that one time, okay? And as soon as possible, because I am taking continuously classes, beta. So within few hours or within 24 hours, your class will be uploaded on my channel, okay?
Yes.
And please just go to my channel, see videos, like videos, and if you a friend, any one of your friend require that, then please, it's my request to give information about my channel to them, okay? Thanks for your time, beta. Have a great time and greetings to your parents. And just your next class, that will be 5:30 as per your time, okay?
5:30.
Yeah, 5:30 as per your time, okay? So thanks a lot. Okay. Have a great time. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much. Bye.